मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम बैक इन अवर वीडियो लेक्चर विद द सेम टॉपिक वाटर अ प्रीशियस रिसोर्स. सो स्टूडेंट इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट वाटर, वॉट आर द डिफरेंट सोर्सेस ऑफ वाटर, वर्ल्ड वाटर डे. ऑल्सो वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ वाटर, सम वाटर प्रॉब्लम्स आर देयर इन अवर सराउंडिंग, ऑल दैट पॉइंट्स वी हैव डिस्कस. सो स्टूडेंट यू ऑल नो वॉट आर द, टेल मी वॉट आर द सोर्सेस ऑफ वाटर. Yes, we get water from nearby sources like lakes, rivers, ponds, then sea, ocean, streams, wells, hand pumps, tube wells, all these are sources of water. And the water in cities and in villages also, the water is supplied through a network of pipes. But what happens, student? Many villages do not have such water supply system, and there people fetch water directly from the sources. Often women and children have to walk several kilometers to fetch water, and that's why children suffer a lot from this. They cannot attend school regularly since they spend more time in fetching water. So in our local areas or in our surrounding, many people, even they are not getting enough water for drinking. They have to spend much time in fetching water, and that's why we have to think about this water problem. So a large number of people draw water from wells, tube wells or hand pumps. So student, what do you think, from where do these sources get water? So all water from wells, tube wells and hand pumps comes from groundwater. Then what is groundwater? Yes, the water below the surface which we get from below the surface area of earth, means water which we get under the surface of earth, it is called groundwater. So we have discussed about this in sources of water. So there are two types of sources of water, surface sources of water and underground surface underground sources of water. So groundwater means the water which is present below the earth's surface, it is called groundwater. So how this groundwater collected below the earth's surface? When rainwater falls on the earth, and also many sources of waters are there. So what will happen as this water flows on the earth, this water seeps into the earth because of porous nature of soil. So you know, you have studied about what is the different layers of, what are the different layers of soil. So this soil is porous in nature, so when water flows on the ground, then it will seeps into the ground because of porous nature of soil, and all the water get collected below the surface of earth, and it is called groundwater. So if we dig a hole in the ground near water body, we may find that the soil is moist, and the moisture in the soil indicates the presence of water underground. If we just dig deeper and deeper, then what will happen? We reach the space, or we reach water below the earth's surface, and the upper limit of this layer is called water table. So what is water table, student? If you just dig the ground deeper and deeper, then you will reach water, and the upper layer of that groundwater layer is called water table. The water table varies from place to place, and it may even change at a given place. The water table may be at a depth of less than meter, or maybe several meters below the ground. The water found below the water table is called groundwater. So one more definition is there. The water found below the water table is called groundwater. And what is the water table? Water table is the upper limit of the groundwater layer. It is called water table. Then the rainwater and water from other sources such as rivers, ponds, seeps through the soil, and it just go deep into the soil, and it fills the empty spaces and cracks deep below the ground. And this process of seeping water into ground, it is called infiltration. So what is infiltration? The process of seeping water into the ground is called infiltration. The groundwater does get recharged by this process, means we are continuously using water from hand pumps, tube wells. Then how this water get recharged? So this water get recharged by the process of infiltration. What is infiltration? Infiltration is the process of seeping water into the ground, and by this process of infiltration, all the water get recharged, ground water get recharged by this process. At places, ground water is stored between layers of hard rock below the water table. So student, in 5th standard we have studied about different layers of soil. So what is the last layer of soil? It's a bedrock. Hard rock is present. So if water get collected, water fill up the space between layers of hard rock below the water table, and this is called aquifer. So you can see in the diagram what is aquifer, what is water table. So first layer is called water table, and at the end means at the end of that soil layer, bedrock is there, and that is the layer where water get collected. It is called aquifer. So water in the aquifers can be usually pump out with the help of tube wells and hand pumps. So what happens, student, this aquifer, it is the layer of hard rock. These rocks are also porous in nature, so water get collected here also, you can see in the diagram. So when all the water means at the places where groundwater is stored between layers of hard rock. So there you can see here, last layer is also bedrock, and this rock is porous in nature, so water just seeps into this, and it is just collected between the layers of hard rock. That is called aquifer. So students, have you ever been to a site where construction work is going on? Okay, so from where do the workers get water for construction? Maybe you have seen boring being done at such sites to reach water table. So this boring, have you heard about boring? Means I think you have seen this bore well. So this bore well means it also means get water from that water table. Means when it just we just dig deep inside the earth, then we will reach that water table. So this is about groundwater. So I hope you got all points related to groundwater. What is mean by, what is groundwater? The water present below the water table, or the water which we found below the earth's surface is called groundwater. What is infiltration? Infiltration is the process of seeping water into the ground. And what is aquifer? Aquifer means what? The groundwater is stored between layers of hard rock below the water table. It is called aquifer. Means below the water table, at the end, there is a hard rock, layer of hard rock, bedrock. And these rocks are also porous in nature, so water get collected between that places. It is called aquifer. What is water table? Water table is upper limit of the groundwater level. It is called water table. So these are the important points. I hope you got all points related to this. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you.